So what is going on everyone, this is Fabi here and today I'm going to talk about the programming languages I choose to learn if I were to start over again. So as this short little introduction tells you, this is basically the list I wish I had back in 2013 or whenever I started learning programming, because if I had this list or a video like this one, I would basically be able to learn programming and the way that you can learn it the best by picking up the right skills to become a great programmer. So I'm actually going to be talking about three programming languages. I'm going to tell you exactly why I picked them and exactly what sort of skills each and every one of those is going to develop for you. Now, there are of course other ways you can start learning programming. There are other approaches, there are other languages you can start with, but this is sort of my personal perspective. Before going into the list, I can tell you that I have about 2.5 years of experience in this field, and while that doesn't make me a senior software engineer or something like that, it definitely does give me an understanding of the field in general. Now, before we start, I just want to mention that this is going to be part of a playlist I'm going to be creating, which is going to be called Let's Code and Create Great Stuff. So if you want to watch any programming or just side project sort of videos, make sure to go ahead and check that playlist out. So without further ado, let's actually start talking about those three programming languages I'm going to recommend. The first one that I'm going to recommend is Python. Now, I think it's really important to choose a language at first that is going to be easy to learn, that's going to have a lot of support from communities online, and Python is exactly that. Because it's such a general purpose language, you can build all sorts of stuff with it. It's starting to get used in a lot of software use nowadays because it's so easy to expand it. You have so many frameworks, so many libraries available for you that you can manage through its package manager, and it's so easy and intuitive, which is something that I cannot say for a lot of the other legacy languages. I feel like the syntax is easy to understand at first because you don't have any curly braces. I remember back when I started learning, this was actually one of the pain points for me, remembering to close all of the brackets and just keeping track of the brackets. I think that this is one of those things that people just have problems with at first because it's not usual to use so many brackets when writing in just natural language. So with programming languages, Python is actually pretty close to natural language. It's just got this flow that makes it seem like English, basically. Another cool feature of Python is the fact that it is object-oriented, but you don't have to use the paradigms of object-oriented programming if you're just starting out. So you can create simple scripts that don't have anything to do with objects or stuff like that. Don't worry if you're new and you don't know what objects or classes are. You don't even need to learn that stuff right now with Python. You can sort of postpone it until later. And to give you some examples about what you can do with Python when you're just getting started, you can, for example, do a basic web scraping script. So you can choose a website which has information that you're interested in and just scrape it, so basically pull it off the web and just dump it into a spreadsheet. Or you can do something with a Raspberry Pi. There's an endless amount of projects you can do with Raspberry Pi and Python, and I'm actually going to plug my recent Raspberry Pi Python project right now, so you can watch the video by clicking on the card that's going to be popping up on the screen right now. But again, the possibilities are unlimited. There's even frameworks for GUIs. You can build a lot of stuff. I can guarantee you, you're not going to be bored with it. And just to sort of seal the deal for Python, if you guys didn't know, Python is actually the most used programming language in the world at the moment. So yeah, pretty great stuff. The second programming language I'm going to recommend is going to be C. Now, actual bare C, not C++, because I think a good programmer has to have the hardware in mind. And with higher level programming languages, you sort of forget that there is a hardware down there and you're just creating high level functions, stuff that doesn't interact with the actual hardware that you're running your code on. And the reason why I think this is important is because it gives you a sort of perspective on how important optimizing is, and it's something that is often forgotten nowadays. Because I'm talking about C, I feel like it's important to give you guys an example of where you can use C in practice. And one of these platforms, this is the Texas Instruments LaunchPad, the cheapest one. The microcontroller on it only has 256 bytes of RAM and 16 kilobytes of flash memory. So this sort of gives you a perspective of the sort of resources you have when using C embedded on something like this. So you can't just go all willy-nilly and include standard C libraries such as standard input output, because that would basically push the limits of the flash on this microcontroller and you wouldn't even get any of your own code on it because there's no space for something like that. So being constrained by the hardware just develops a sort of skill set that I think a lot of developers need, and it's actually why I'm encouraging every developer to at least at some point in their career experiment with something like this. Now, talking about C, yes, it's going to be more difficult to learn than Python, but because you started learning Python, you've sort of learned a few concepts that you don't have to learn anymore, so you can focus on the syntax, which is more complex, but don't have to focus on everything like I did at first. So I started learning programming by learning C at first, which just wasn't the most natural way to learn programming, I feel like, and I did go through with it, but I feel like if you're not as motivated as I was, maybe you're just going to give up because some things can irk you. There's a lot of stuff that there's more complex, for example, memory management and stuff like that, which with Python is just a lot more seamless. Just as with Python, there's a lot of communities that are active around C, so you're always going to be able to find the questions you are seeking. As for projects that I recommend you guys do, again, I talked about microcontrollers. I actually recommend you guys pick up one of those from Texas Instruments. They are great for beginners. And the one that I just showed to you is really great at first because it's easy enough to understand and it sort of gives you a introduction into the microcontroller world. If you're actually interested in picking one of those up, I'm actually going to put a link in the description to Amazon. The third language I'm going to talk about is actually going to be two languages. So you can actually choose whichever one of these you want because they serve the same purpose as far as I'm concerned. And those are going to be Java or C++. Now, the reason why I chose these two and the reason why I say that they're basically interchangeable if you're starting to learn programming is because they are sort of the definition of high-level programming languages. If you want to learn object-oriented programming, and I do recommend you guys learn it the right way, these two programming languages are going to be great for that. You'll be happy to know that they're both used quite extensively in companies, especially in large companies that have infrastructure that was built over a long period of time. Java is the backend for a lot of web apps. It's the programming language that a lot of PC apps were actually built in. C++ is heavily used in games. It's heavily used in environments where scalability is an issue, so you can scale up your application whenever needed. So because of reasons that we are not going to touch in this video because it would make this video just way too long, Java is more portable because you can run the same code on different platforms, and C++ is more resource effective. Java basically runs in a virtual machine, whereas C++ is compiled and actually returns machine code. But this is just way too complicated for the first step. At first, you need to learn the syntax and where you would actually use these languages. I would actually recommend most of you guys to pick Java just because it has a friendlier syntax, especially for beginners, and because it's got a native library you can use to build GUIs. Now, this library is regarded as outdated, but if you're a beginner, it's going to be great to build GUIs, especially with an IDE that supports just drag and drop of the elements, so you can drag buttons, you can drag text fields and stuff like that in your interface, and then just write the code to implement the behavior without having to create all of the objects that would be the buttons, the panels, and the whole interface. So yeah, these are the programming languages that I wish I had learned back when I started learning. Now, I watched some videos on YouTube before actually doing this video, and a lot of people are recommending JavaScript, HTML and stuff like that. But if you were to start with HTML though, I feel like it would take you a lot longer to transition into C or other programming languages, which is why I didn't choose that route for this video. JavaScript, on the other hand, if you started with these three programming languages, it's not going to be an issue for you. You're going to be able to learn that pretty quickly. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any ideas for future programming or just side project, hardware, all sorts of tech interesting things, basically ideas for videos that you want to see on my channel, make sure to leave those ideas in the comment section down below. Make sure to like this video, share with your friends on Facebook and on Twitter, and subscribe for more awesome content. Stay tuned. Peace out, guys. Peace.